It is a gargantuan construction project. Placing metal aqueduct structures in and around valleys, arroyos, sheer mountains, long, flat, dry expanses of the California landscape. It's astonishing.
Think that you could bring that water over 200 miles, that's just extraordinary at the time. It would be a huge project today.
On that November day in 1913, when Angelenos gathered at the Cascades to celebrate the opening of the aqueduct, they were captivated by the city's glittering future. Shortly after 1 p.m., Owens River water was released down the Cascades for the first time.
People just rushed toward the water. They had brought tin cups to dip into the water as it was coming down to drink the first water from this man-made river.
As the crowd rushed to marvel at their new river, Mulholland perfectly captured the moment. "There it is," he shouted from the stage. "Take it."
The aqueduct was a game changer. It made Los Angeles the fastest growing city in the United States.
The aqueduct teaches Los Angeles that it can do bold and amazing things.
Suburbs are springing up all over, and migrants are pouring into Los Angeles. It was a moment of great excitement.
That's not to say this works for everybody by any stretch of the imagination. There's racial segregation in law and in practice. There's violence meted out to non-whites. So it's not an alchemy of fulfillment and happiness that spreads to everybody. But the mythic qualities of it are palpable. The dream was, come here, perhaps start anew.
But as Los Angeles boomed, Southern California was drying up. By the time the population blew past the 1 million mark in the early 1920s, the aqueduct flow had been cut almost in half by years of drought.
Just think about it. They were looking out 50 years, and they were out of water in 10. Surprise, surprise. That's what California's full of. It's full of surprises.